Are you looking at Slack or Microsoft Teams alternatives? Well, today we're going to dive into a software called Zenzap, and we're going to explore some of the features of it and how to get started with it as a way for you and your team to communicate about work. So today's video is kindly sponsored by Zenzap. This is a getting started guide to understanding some of the features. We're going to dive into a couple of the features to give you an insight of whether it's right for you and your team. So let's jump over to the laptop and dive in. So before we begin this video, if you're interested in downloading Zenzap, you can find it linked below. Dive in and get it started with your account there. So this is our Zenzap account, and as you can see, we're Grove and Griddle. We're a team and we're a restaurant using this application to communicate about tasks, group chat, and lots more. So the first thing that's important about this app is it's about group chat and messaging. So you can go ahead and create a brand new group chat here. You can create them as a topic or a group chat. You can just add people, or you can go ahead and center it around something specific. So here's one I created earlier about an office pet. Maybe we're thinking about getting an office pet. That's a good topic to kick things off. I've added a few people here, and what we can do straight away is start adding tasks up in the top right-hand corner. Now, all of the tasks can be assigned to each of your team members, which is a great way to begin assigning stuff to them, making sure they're getting things done. So I can go ahead and add an assignee. I can assign this to Boris, and I can add a description, due date, and sub item. So there we are, I've added an item for Boris to do, and as you can see, it's popped up in the center there to indicate that Boris has a task. Now, the great thing is you have this area called agenda over here. So what's perfect is you can keep an eye on what has been assigned to you and assigned to other people. Now you can click and enter the agenda to see any overdue items. You can even assign it to specific people and ones to yourself. As you can see, I'm all done, but I can go ahead and reset it and type in a topic or a person of what they need to get done. Great for managers, making sure that they're kept updated with their tasks. So you may have noticed there that I have a calendar event coming up, and that's because you can connect up with Google Calendar or Outlook Calendar. It's a great way to sync your items up. I can also go ahead and use this button in the top right-hand corner to create a meeting event for the day. This is perfect for collaborating with somebody and finding the availability for that person. Now I can do that instantly, and as you can see, a Google Meet has been created for me to just jump into the items with Joshua. So over here, you'll notice you've got a favorites area which you can edit, but you've also got an area called All Media, All Tasks, and this is a dedicated area for that. You can also see all the media that has been uploaded, including files and updates as well. And there are a bunch of different integrations that I'll show on screen now, which help you to connect with other popular resources that you may know, love, and use as a team already. So one thing I quite like is you can still DM people inside of this, so you can direct message, and you can also open up new conversations and see all the collaborations. Over here, if you select certain items, you can add it to a to-do list that is part of that chat, or you can reply in private to that person or forward it accordingly. Now, this is really helpful for just making sure that your team are updated on what they need to get done. You can also see the media items and files up here. Now, over in the left-hand corner, you can modify your preferences. Your preferences give you an idea of your working hours, and that's a great way to modify it so people don't disturb you at the wrong time. You can also change over here to light and dark mode for easy access. Now, one final thing you can do over here is you can have your own personal space. This is perfect for adding items that you need to do for the day that are task orientated, as well as being able to manage other chats or notes that you've sent to yourself. I always do this in email, but this could be a good way to do it for you if you're working with your team to make sure you have a little management area for yourself. So hopefully that gave you a better idea of how Zenzap operates. It's an application you can download, start for free, join your team in, and start managing your tasks and your chats all in one place. So find it linked below, and a big thanks to Zenzap for sponsoring today's video to get an idea of how this application operates.